So you might be looking for an aesthetic planner. Maybe it's to feel a bit more cozy when you're managing your tasks, or whatever it might be, we're here to help you find it. All of the list of tools that we mention in this video will be listed below, and I've actually written about it in a little bit more detail if you were interested in that below. Anyway, let's get on with the list. So the first application on the list is known as Sansama. It is a popular one for more mindful planning, and this one's good for busy professionals. It's probably not great if you're somebody that is looking for something much more simple, but this app is a little bit pricier, but it's something that you will like if you're finding yourself in the workplace and you need to focus on quality tasks versus quantity. Not all of the tasks are as important or built equal, so you want to be able to use something that maybe help you skip past that. It's also got a feature called guided planning, which a lot of people like. So the next app on my list is Notion. This one is well known. Notion is a pretty incredible application. You can pretty much build what you want with this app, and it's really, really nice. Now it's simple, easy to use, and has a really aesthetic feel because you can build whatever you want, a mood tracker, all the way up to taking somebody else's template, obviously legally, and basically using it as your base. That could be a habit tracker, that could be a life OS. It is really popular as an aesthetic tool because you can build to the colors that you like and the feel that you want. So many people use this all the way from a mood board to planning their work, whatever suits them. Next on the list is Zineia. Now this one is a really interesting one. It's really attractive if you've got an iPad and you like that Bujo sort of planning feel. This application is really easy to use, and it's designed totally for the Apple stylus. You can use this to plan your family's week meals, whatever it may be, all the way over to planning out your vision board for the future. It's a very visual application. And you can take these like sketchbook type style things and put them together and build your own layout. It's really nice, a little bit sort of like using Canva, but a planner type Canva. It's very aesthetic and you can really design things to how you like. I know a lot of people who use this and love it because of its simple style. Next up is one called Planbella. Now this one is very popular. It's very Instagrammy feeling, and that's because this app is available on iOS and Android, and I believe it's a one-time price download, which is great. A little bit more expensive, I think it's $8.99 on the iOS device, but it is simple. Task notes and simple sort of event management. So you can see all of those things in a feed, and you can even do things like manifesting. So you can write down something that you wanted to focus on or were grateful for during that day, but it's very, very clean and simple. Nothing too massive, if you know what I mean. Next up is Craft. Now this one is a documents application, but weirdly they've got daily planners. So you can journal in here, you can manage your tasks, and then you can go and create this cool document. But what's different with the documents is you can turn them into really fun looking experiences, because all you have to do is add a board around them. You can turn them into like a sepia feel. It is really molding to how cozy you want it to make it feel, which is really nice. Next up is Xtiles, and many people call this one the Notion alternative, and it's great for those visual thinkers among you that like to be able to have that tile layout that helps you to build what you want, but without the complexities of Notion. Because in Xtiles, you can drag things and they sort of shape into a tile-like format. It's great for to-do lists, calendar, and you can use the tabs at the top, which is aesthetic. It sort of feels a bit like a notebook in person, where you can flick through the tabs and find stuff that you need. You can colorize them, really customize this. There's loads of templates in it too. Next up is Routine. This one's a bit of more of a minimal planner app. It connects with Notion, ClickUp, and Slack, so it actually has that work element to it, but it's very easy to use. The aesthetics on the week planner, where you can plan your week, and also the timeline view is stunning. It's a very minimal app, and it's beautiful on your mobile device too. So again, a really popular one. Next up is Trello. A lot of people use Trello because it is really visual. You can move your cards across different places. I know so many people that use it and love it. But what's nice about Trello as well is that it has a new update that allows you to see your calendar, your inbox, and your boards as well. So you can still have that like mood boardy type feel and move stuff around, but now you can have your calendar and your inbox there, not your email inbox, but your inbox of tasks to do, which is really nice for capture. Next up is Structured. I love Structured. It's such an underrated application. Why I like it is because it's great for those who want to organize at home or just want to manage their tasks lightly. The reason I recommend it is because it's good for routine. So if you say to it something like, oh, or if you add in 8 a.m. I'll do this, 10 a.m. I'll do this, and 12 p.m. I'll do this, it comes in like a timeline-like view, which allows you to scroll through and see where you are and what's next, which is really nice. Great and popular for ADHD, naturally. But a lot of people like it because there's a feature in the premium where you can just talk into the app and basically add all your tasks and things you need to get on with. So another really nice one. Finally, if you like a desk plan, if you like to see your week ahead of you, there's an app called Tweak Calendar, and this one's incredibly popular. I highly recommend taking a look at this one if you like to just see everything in front of you and you just want to have that cozy, relaxed feel. This application connects with Google Calendar as well on the premium plan, but has a lovely little bird as its icon. So you know it's a very relaxed app with the name Tweak. It's very chill. So if you liked any of these apps I mentioned, you can find them in the link in the description. As always, you can search them over on toolfinder.co and explore all of our resources over there. Thank you very much for stopping by. And if you want more detail on this, check out the article. I'm sure it's a good read if you're finding the right perfect aesthetic planner app. Thanks very much and see you soon.